TMZ begins here.
Where? Yeah. Yes. Yes.
Exactly.
This is it right here.
The gate we entered.
Yeah. This is the demand.
That was the entrance of the.
Anyway, it's like jumping down to the subway and touching one of the rails. Subway. The same electricity that's used for a subway.
So it's pretty. It's 1,000 volts?
I figure approximately 1,000 volts, yes.
And what's behind the bridge?
So you will try it.
And we are going to shout the slogans with the microphone. Come with a loudspeaker. Okay. Then. What slogans we are going? We are going to say Korea's one. Korea's one in Korea. Chosonun Hanada!
Chosonun Hanada!
Another we are going to say Yankee go home!
Yankee go home!
Yankee go home!
Yankee go home!
Panting Pamunjo.
Say again.
Alex,
what? Say again,
and louder. Yeah, no problem. From South Korea. Pamunjon is right there. We are now in the border, okay? We are going to be just in the line. If you visit Pamunjon from South Korean side, the first thing the American and South Koreans will tell you is that this building is fake, that this is a decoration, that we don't have money to build houses, and we are dying. So this is a demonstration, this building, that the South Koreans lie. And this same lie is spread in all the media. This is the famous building. They say it's a decoration. So please let the world and all the friends know the lies of the American media. Thank you.
First of all, we'll have a look at the Pamunjom area. So this way, please.
This is the DMZ, the north of the south.
The white Charles Bronson poses behind me, just poke out with some corner.
Run by United States.
좌우 양옆에 나무 사이로 보이는 푸른 건물들이 이곳 조성입니다.
U.S. military post.
이렇게 하나의 조선 민족이 군사분계선을 사이에 두고 50년이 넘도록 국가 나무를 세우도록 빌렸습니다.
The Korean people are still facing the tragical division for over 50 years.
Tourist bus coming from the south.
앞에 문제가 나오지 지난 시기 군사분계선을 사이에
The building with open the door, that's where we have met.
Battle of the tourists.
Watching.
Oh, this is so funny.
The armored car which has just passed away, that's the armored car from the south side, South Korea side.
It's not an armored car, it's a Hummer.
Actually, it is law, it is a regulation to forbid any armored car or armistice weapons.
Please come nearer. This side. And then,
is the United States behind this? They put the South Korean soldiers in front to show. But look, up there, the American commander, they are the one dividing the Korean Peninsula. And they put the South Koreans in front just for a showcase for us. They also flag the United Nations flag when they are not authorized by them. The United Nations doesn't authorize this. It's a purely American division. Yes? This is very important. Look up there, the colonels and generals from the United States perpetuating the division of the Korean Peninsula. They are the guilty ones. They are the ones that are making the Korean people failing to be reunited again.
The soldiers above the balcony over there, the in uniform, they are the U.S. soldiers, officers.
But the ones down low, the ones here, are U.S.?
No, these
are the South Korean soldiers in U.S. uniform.
Oh, all right.
The South Korean are just puppets of them. These are the warlords, the criminals, up there controlling South Korea. There will be one day that the South Koreans will realize that. And then that Yankees will go home. Huh? Yankees, go home! Yankees, go home!
The border is only about 100... The border is only 100... The border is less than 100 yards... 3, 2, 1. I'm standing right on the border, and that's about as close as most people will ever get to North Korea. In fact, security is so tight that should anybody try to cross the border, they could run the risk of being shot. Although Seoul is only an hour in that direction on the South Korean side of the border, if I wanted to get there, I would first need to travel to Pyongyang, then fly to China, before getting on another plane to take me to South Korea.
So often when we ask to do something, there's a reason we say, oh, well, there's no time on the schedule, or we must stick to the schedule.
Please, let's see that. We didn't make the schedule ourselves.
And I didn't either. But there's sometimes there's the time becomes available.
Oh, excuse me. What? We are, you know, we are doing our best. But some of you have the wrong impression, wrong impact.
How?
You've just heard what he's saying,
right?
So if you say that one go to there to A place and B go to B place and C won't go to C place, then how can a group can be organized? So what we teach from the childhood is that you should cultivate the team spirit, and because you are living in a society, not living alone.
We had no part in the schedule. We didn't play. We didn't decide the schedule at all.
Then who decided? We didn't.
We didn't either.
Then who is it?
Maybe
the ghost?
Maybe Alejandro.
But we saw that you have discussion with him.
I mean, the schedule is very good, but. When you come here...
No, I don't think that the schedule is very good because most of you are just asking to show us these things and these things and these things.
Part of the problem is that when we get to the d.p.r.k, we learn about things that we didn't know existed and we didn't know were here. And so we didn't even know to think to ask you to put them on the schedule. So when we learn about them, that's when we ask to see them. And that's part of the problem. Are we still friends?
Sure.
All right.
Time to get fine. Stop for a second. We gotta have you stop.
Everybody's just coming.
Yeah, but tell them anyway. Stop. We need you to stop.
Okay, shall I get into the bus, please?
We came to your country during a friendly video with solidarity to the Korean people. And just how to achieve national recognition and peace on the Korean Peninsula. First of all, I, in the name of the participants in the National March for Korea's Peace and Unification, would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to the Korean community for peaceful relations with foreign countries and the entire Korean people.